I am finally back with another nail tutorial. If you guys follow me on Pinterest or Instagram, you guys know that I love, love, love painting my nails, and I'm really into nail art. So a trend that I'm really into is called the party nail, and that's where you paint one nail, usually the middle finger, sometimes the pointer, honestly it could be anyone that you want. You just paint one nail a different color from the rest of your nails, and it's usually something really sparkly, like a gold glitter or a metallic or a confetti color, and that's why it's been called the party nail. I decided to take it up a notch, add a little rhinestones to my party nail. We all know I'm secretly a grandma. I'm obsessed with gold and sequins and glitter and sparkly stuff. And my golden birthday is coming up. When you turn the same age as your birthday, I'm turning 29. I'm trying to be excited and not freak out about that. So I thought, what better way to celebrate my golden birthday than with some sparkly golden rhinestone goodness on my nails. It's really, really easy, so let's go ahead and get started. All this information will be in the video description box, but just in case, I'm using this ridge filling base coat from Nail Tech. The color I've chosen is Sally Hansen Smooth and Perfect in Dune number 3, and the top coat I'm using is called Cevecevete. I have no idea how to say it. It's a little expensive at almost $12, but it's the best top coat ever, and it's totally worth it. Also using a generic 100% acetone from Duane Reade, along with a nail art brush and a small pair of tweezers, and of course I've got these little jewels. Now I picked these up from Michael's craft store, but you can also find them online. Links will be in the video description box, of course. And it sounds like a no-brainer, but to start, I put all of my rhinestones on a little napkin. And the reason for that is that you don't want to be opening packaging or digging into a bag when your nails are wet. So of course I start with my base coat before putting on my nail polish color. And when you put your nail polish on, you want to make sure to wrap your nails, which means that the nail polish kind of goes along the edge of your nail, just getting a little tiny bit under the nail. This is going to make your nail polish last longer and not chip. After you paint your nails, I use my brush in a little bit of acetone to clean up around the edges, especially in that cuticle area where nail polish tends to pool and build up. This just makes your nail polish look a lot neater and more professional. I put my top coat on my party nail of choice and then use my little tweezers to add the rhinestones to my nail. Now, as you drop them on there, you want to tap them a little bit so that they set into that top coat. There's no rhyme or reason here. I'm just putting them in a little cluster on my nail. And when you're done, go ahead and add that top coat back onto the nail, making sure to wrap it. This will make sure that those stones stay on there for as long as possible. I clean up a little bit with the acetone and then add the top coat to the rest of my nails. Easy as pie. So there you have it, super easy and really beautiful. Let me know in the comments below if you are into nail art and what your favorite trends are. And if you aren't already, make sure that you are following me on Instagram and Pinterest. I will put links to those in the video description box. I post lots and lots of pictures of hairstyles and clothes and stuff that inspire me. And I also share Lockstar photos from my Facebook fan page. So make sure that you are following me if you aren't already. Thanks so much, guys. I will see you later. Bye. Next level. This sounds stupid. I'm obsessed with gold. I'm obsessed with gold. Why can't I talk?